गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माई सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर 3। आई होप यू हैव वॉच माई फर्स्ट वीडियो वेर हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ वायरसेस, देयर इफेक्ट्स, देयर सिम्टम्स एंड द प्रिवेंटिंग मेजर्स। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अदर मैलवेयर्स। अपार्ट फ्रॉम वायरसेस देयर आर मेनी अदर मैलवेयर्स। सम ऑफ देम आर ट्रोजन हॉर्स, वर्म, स्पाईवेयर, स्वीपर एंड एडवेयर। सो वन बाई वन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस मैलवेयर। एट फर्स्ट ट्रोजन हॉर्स। This is a program that appears to be safe but damages the computer once it runs. It pretends as a useful safe program, but whenever we will run it in our computer, it damages the computer. Trojans do not reproduce by infecting other files like viruses, nor do they replicate. That means like virus, it cannot replicate itself to infect other files. A Trojan can spread only when it is copied from one system to another system, generally using some secondary storage media, pen drive, CD, DVD, external hard drive. It can damage files, break password, make unauthorized transfer of money from your account to their account, means developer's account, or unnecessarily download or upload files. Some example of Trojan horses are Acid Rain, Crack, Wando, etc. Now here in page number 35, we will find one info box where we will get to know about the history of Trojan horse. This is not very important for your exam, so you can go through this, but no need to memorize this. Next one is Worm. It's a program that copies itself from one computer to another over a network. That means through network, this Worm spread from one computer to another. Unlike a virus, Worm is capable of running itself and does not need a host program. So virus always needs a host program. It attached with a file, and whenever it will open that file in the application, that application get infected by the virus. After that, whenever it will create a new file or open any existing file in that application, all file will be infected by the virus. A worm is designed only to spread from one system to another, not to cause the changes in data of the system they pass through. That means they cannot infect any file. They can infect a full computer. Some example of worms are Code Rain, Slammer Worm, Storm, etc. Next is Spyware. It's a type of malware designed to collect information about the internet surfing habit and frequently visited website by the user. As the name suggested, it works as a spy on our computer and it finds out your activity in a computer and in internet. On the basis of the website visited by the user, advertisement starts appearing on your screen of the computer system in the form of banners and pop-ups. This you know, at the time of surfing in internet, sometimes advertisement comes on your interest. How they come to know about your interest? Because the spyware is there in your computer or in browser or in the website where you are surfing. So this spyware always collects information about your surfing habit and it monitors your activity in internet. And based on that, spyware finds out your interest and sends that information to the advertising company, and they keeps on displaying the advertisement on your interest at the time of surfing in internet on your browser. The spyware is different from other type of malware as it does not multiply. It only installs itself once on the computer of the user. That means one copy of spyware will remain in your computer. The spyware uses your computer memory and resources to track your activity, obviously, because the spyware is installed in your machine. The presence of spyware in the system reduces the operating speed and the connection speed of the computer. That means it reduces the speed of your computer and speed of your internet. Look2Me is an example of spyware. Then Sweeper. It is also one type of spyware that is difficult to detect and remove. It reinstalls itself even after it is removed from the computer. That means whenever you are removing, it keeps a copy back of it. Computer may get infected by Sweeper while downloading a software. Means it attaches with a software, and whenever you will download the software from internet to your computer, that spyware get installed in your system. A spyware may get installed through a Trojan horse that appears harmless, such as Windows notification or a pop-up ads. But when you click on any button on that pop-up or the notification, the spyware gets downloaded on your system. Then adware. As the name suggested, adware means advertising supported software. Adware is used to display advertisement in the form of banners, pop-ups, and unclosable windows on the infected computer. That means if your computer is infected by adware, adware will keep on showing the advertisement, pop-ups, and modal window, means unclosable window, at the time of surfing in internet. Adware is generally bundled with the application purchased from the market or downloaded from the internet. Sometimes adware are used by the software developer to collect fund from the development of the software. They makes a free version of their software and they attach a adware with their software to inform the user of their software to donate some money for their further development. Some adware act as a spyware to send information about the user's online activities to other adware developers. Okay, so we have discussed about few malwares. Now we will learn about antivirus software. All of you know what is antivirus software? So let's see. Antivirus software is a set of programs that are used to detect and remove viruses and other malwares from our computer. Antivirus software as antivirus. So this is the software which searches for the virus in all the files and folders of the computer system and removes them. Some antivirus softwares are freely available on the internet. Examples, Avira Free, AVG Free, Bitdefender, Panda Cloud, and so on. You can download any of this software from the internet without paying any money. But some antivirus softwares we have to purchase. They are paid version. Examples, McAfee, Kaspersky, Avast, Norton, QuickHeal, Malwarebytes, and so on. Paid antivirus software generally offers more features than free ones. Most of the antivirus company, they provide their free version as well as paid version. The free version comes with limited feature, whereas paid version will come with fully featured software. Okay. Now here in Infobox, you will find the firewall, which is very important. What is firewall? A firewall is a software program that protects our computer from hackers, viruses, and worms that try to infect it over the internet. So firewall, we have to keep active in our system. If you have genuine Windows operating system, with Windows operating system, Windows firewall comes, which you have to update frequently. Now we will learn how antivirus software works. Antivirus software is made to run and scan computer system wholly or partially. That means you can scan the full computer system, means full memory and hard disk, or you can scan your hard disk or RAM partially. One folder, one drive, few files, or one secondary memory. After the system scan, if some viruses are detected, then depending upon the nature of the virus, the following actions are to be taken. What are those? Quarantining, repairing, and deleting. So first action is quarantining. Quarantining means to place an infected things in a place of isolation where it cannot harm others. Quarantining a file is usually the first action that an antivirus software takes when it detects a virus. This is just like a ward. Whenever antivirus detects a file is virus infected, it sends that virus to that virus ward from where that virus cannot infect other files or your computer. Next is repairing. The antivirus tries to remove the virus code from the infected file and restores the files to its original form. This is better than quarantining it. It tries to repair the file to restore the file in its original form. That means it tries to recover the file. And last is deleting. If the file cannot be recovered, if it is totally damaged or infected by dangerous virus, then antivirus software will decide to delete. Sometimes after detecting a virus, antivirus software asks user what to do. Whether to send the file in virus vault or to try to repair it or to delete the file. According to our response, antivirus software will react. Here it is a suggestion for you. You must regularly scan your computer using antivirus software to detect and delete viruses from it. And you must update your antivirus software frequently. Then Infobox. You must read this. This is very important for short question. The very first computer virus was the creeper virus that was detected on ARPANET in the early 1970s. ARPANET is the first network in the world. And this network was infected by the first virus called creeper virus. Then after that, using an antivirus software. This we will not learn because here it is discussed about 360 total security. But we may have other antivirus software in our system, so no need to go through these steps. You can very well open your antivirus software which is there in your system and you can operate that antivirus software also to detect virus and remove virus. Okay. So we have completed this chapter. Now you read this chapter thoroughly line by line and solve all the let's review and exercise of this chapter. In my next class, I will provide the solution of this let's review. Two let's reviews are there and the exercise question answers. So till our next class, bye. Have a nice day.